Anderson Cooper 360, weeknights at 8 and 10 on CNN.
For Jim Pritchard, it's planting season. The past few days have been long and hard, sowing corn seed.
How many acres here?
There's approximately 80 acres here.
He's done for the day. Soon, the sun will set. But by morning, all his hard work could be ruined and his seeds stolen under the cover of darkness.
1 year and two nights, I lost 18 acres.
18 acres in two nights?
Yes, sir.
And that's worth how much to you?
That wound up costing me in lost yield about $9,000.
But thieves are not the problem.
And what has that problem been?
Well, the pigs root up the corn seed after you plant it.
Wild pigs, hogs, annihilate corn, peanuts, beans, virtually any crop on Pritchard's 700 acres.
This is evidence that they've been here?
Yes, sir. That was overnight, last night.
A few rows devoured. Hoof prints are in the dirt.
This is nothing. I mean, this, you know, if that's all there is, I'll be happy.
Some mornings are much worse. Ruined crops as far as the eye can see.
These wild hogs come through this area so often, they have worn a path through this field. And look at this. This is where they scrape the mud off on the pine trees. You can see it on the bark there. Look at this one. It's happened so often that about 2.5 feet of the bark has been scraped off. Now, this is a national problem. The USDA estimates there are about 4 to 5 million wild hogs in America, and they cause about $1.5 billion worth of crop damage a year.
Pritchard is frustrated. He's tried everything to nurture his crops.
To get it done, you need a few basic tools. You need your seeds.
Yep.
You need your tractor. You need sunlight and water. And apparently you need an AR-15 too.
I need a good man with a good gun.
I'm a good man and this is a great gun.
He's Hal Schaus, and that's one of his six AR-15s. It is the gun of choice for hog hunters because it's light, easy to carry, and has little recoil. Hal works for 16 farmers covering nearly 100,000 acres.
We don't discriminate. We kill them all. Big boar, a mama with a bunch of little footballs, they all catch a bullet.
His company is Hog Swat, and that's no exaggeration. Schaus uses top-of-the-line tactical gear, night vision, and thermal imaging to find and kill hogs.
I do this as a free service to my farmers, and in exchange, they allow me to bring paying customers.
$500 per customer to train these crosshairs, everyone from experienced big game hunters to preteen novices.
It's a blast. It's, you know, it's legitimately the coolest thing you could legally do with an AR or any weapon.
Schaus invited us along on a hunt, so we loaded up the ambulance and hit the rough and winding dirt roads of South Georgia.
I'm out five nights a week, four to seven nights a week, depending on the season. If it, you know, now they're planting, so I'm out almost seven nights a week. You learn them.
Farm after farm, it seemed the hogs' timing was better than ours, so we pulled into a farm and waited.
We're right in the middle of a 700-acre field. We've got 1,200 yards, 1,300 yards in any direction that's tree line, that's open. We'll see them come out of the tree line. I'll have time to gear up and go at them.
While we waited, we talked about that gear at the center of a national battle.
You know, when you say AR-15 and 30-round mag, that's a political hot button.
Sure it is. Because people have decided to make it one. You know, tragedies happened, but the weapon didn't create these tragedies. Sick individuals used this weapon, this tool, and they did something destructive with it, something ugly. And there's just nothing else you can say about it.
Then one more infrared scan of the field, and there he was, a boar, roughly 400 yards away. We all rush out and stealthily approach. Schaus steadies his AR-15.
This is a pretty average size. He's probably a buck 30, buck 40.
For Hog Swat and the farmers of South Georgia, success.
The question has been repeatedly, who needs this weapon outside of the military or someone who wants to kill someone else?
Well, I mean, need is that's a big word, you know. You don't need a lot of things that you choose to use because they make your job easier. I could do this with a single shot weapon. I wouldn't be near as effective. I could do it, but I don't want to. I'm a legal, responsible gun owner. I evaluated all of the different weapons out there, and I decided that this weapon is the what makes sense for me and my company.
Victor, a lot of controversies obviously surrounded the use of high-capacity magazines. Could these hunters do the same job with smaller magazines?
He says yes, he can do it, but he would not be as effective. And here's why, because he says in the hunt you just watched, there was just one boar. But if there'd been a sow with maybe 12 babies, which is not unusual because they can have up to 12 a few times a year, he would need all 30 rounds to fire off in quick repetition. And there's one other thing I got to show you. It's like CSI South Georgia out here. The pigs have been back. And here's the evidence. You've got hoof prints here. The pigs have been back, and that means, Anderson, that Hal Schaus will be back. He says that he's going to stay in this area, cover those 100,000 acres until he tries to get rid of this population.